Hello everyone, welcome to this video lecture. Myself Dipali Wadkar, working as assistant professor at WIT Solapur. In this video lecture we'll study solar cells. At the end of this video lecture, student will be able to examine working of solar cells. Student will be able to state applications of solar cells. Solar cell, it is the device which convert the solar energy, that is energy obtained from sun, directly into electrical energy. It is also called as photogalvanic cell. The basic principle behind the working of solar cell is depend upon photovoltaic effect. Now what is the photovoltaic effect? Whenever light energy is allowed to fall on solar cell generate voltage across its terminal. So this is called as a photovoltaic effect. As the intensity of light increases, the voltage also increases. Now this is the constructional diagram for solar cell. Mainly solar cells are constructed by using crystalline silicon which consists of p-type and n-type semiconductor. Okay. These p-type and n-type semiconductors are sandwiched to each other. Due to this, there is a p-n junction between p and n-type semiconductor. The upper layer, that is here, the n-type semiconductor, its layer is thin so that light can easily enter inside the material. Solar cells are metallized with thin strips which are painted on front and rear contact. These strips are called as a finger and these strips are called as a bus bar. Its purpose to conduct the DC power which are generated by this solar cell. The single solar cell generate a voltage across it. That voltage is in the range of 0.5 volt to 0.8 volt. So this voltage is very small. So this different combination of solar cells are used to increase its efficiency. Okay. So there may be parallel combination, there may be serial combination, there may be parallel and serial combination. Okay. So these combinations of solar cells is called as a solar module. Okay. On the both sides of this solar cell, these EVA sheets are used, which are used to protect this solar cell from shocks, from vibration, as well as from dust. So this is the construction of solar module. The single solar cell, by using its different combination, there is a solar module. By using different combination of solar module, there is a solar panel. And by using different combination of solar panel, there is a solar array. Now the working principle behind the solar cell. This is the n-type semiconductor which consists majority charge carrier electron. This is the p-type semiconductor which consists majority charge carrier holes. When n-type and p-type semiconductor connected to each other, the electrons from n-type start diffusing into the p-type. Okay, and due to this, they start neutralizing the atom and there is a formation of depletion region. Okay, once the depletion region generated, here the potential barrier generated across, that is the electric field generated, and due to that the majority charge carriers cannot cross the junction. Okay. So once this depletion region generated, majority charge carriers stays on their position. Now question, when external energy is applied to depletion region, what is the effect on depletion region? Okay, so in the previous lecture we have seen, so what is the effect of external energy on the depletion region? Pause the video for a while and think. Yes, whenever the external energy, that is the sunlight, strikes on the depletion region, the whole electron pair generated, that is due to the photons, the silicon atoms get excited and the free electrons generated and hence the holes also generated. Now due to this electric field, these electrons cannot cross the junction. So these electrons stays on the n side and the holes stays on p side. So large number of excess electrons present here at the n side, and large number of excess holes present here the p side. Okay. So negative charge is generated towards the n side, and positive charge is generated towards the p side. Okay. Now when these two terminals connected to each other by using single cable, then these electrons from n side start attracting towards the p side, and due to this, this electron flows through the cable, and due to this, the current is generated. Okay, so the current flows through this cable. Okay, so in this way, whenever the light strikes on the solar cell, the voltage across the solar cell generated or electric field is generated. Now the types of solar cell, there are basically two types of solar cell, monocrystalline and polycrystalline. Monocrystalline solar cells, they are the premium solar cells. So these solar cells uses a single crystal, so it is called as a monocrystalline. So to make the cells of monocrystalline panel, the silicon is formed into bars and cut into wafers. Now second type, that is the polycrystalline. The efficiency of polycrystalline solar cell less as compared to monocrystalline, but its advantage that its cost is low. Okay. So to make the cells of polycrystalline panels, fragments of silicons are melted together to form the wafers. It is also called as a multicrystalline. Next, that is the application of solar cell. The solar cells which are connected to the inverter, so this system can be used for a home appliances. The inverters which converts the DC from solar cell into AC energy, and this AC energy is now then distributed to the home appliances and lighting system. Okay. Now in case of solar cell, it is not necessary that separate structure should be there, but the solar cell can be structured on the surface of home. Solar cell with battery storage system can be used for a lighting purpose. The solar cell used in a communication system, that is some of the towers are far away from a power distribution system. So in that case, the solar cell is an alternative energy source. Solar cells can be used in a remote areas where distribution system or power lines are far away from that area. So in that case, provide the electricity, the solar cell is an alternating way. Scientific experiment setups are far away from a power distribution system. So to provide the electricity for such system, the solar cells are used. Now in navigational systems such as lighthouses, highways and aircraft warning signals can be far away from a electricity grid. So in that case, to provide the electricity, the solar system or PV systems are used. The vehicles running on electric power can be charged by PV powered stations. So this is the one of the example how the vehicles are get charged with the help of solar system. Then solar system can be used for applications like storage and transport of medicines and vaccines that requires a refrigeration. The solar systems used in a public utilities like in telephone booth or teller system. The solar systems becomes a perfect candidate for agriculture and livestock purposes due to need for water during the periods with the bright sunshine. Now next, the advantages of solar system. It is clean and non-polluting. It is renewable energy. Solar cells do not produce noise and they are totally silent. They require very little maintenance. There are no fuel cost or fuel supply problem. Next, disadvantages. Solar power can't be obtained in night time. Solar panels are very expensive. Energy has not to be stored in battery. Air pollution and weather can affect the production of electricity. They need large areas of land to produce more efficient power supply. Now these are the references. Thank you.